Greetings from the Sephardic Temple of Cedarhurst. Have you heard that in Brooklyn, people are taught that if they do not believe that the plague of frogs were normal frogs, they are heretics? Seemingly, they must believe that one huge frog, like a Godzilla frog, came out of the Nile River. And then, according to this thesis, the people hit the frog with a stick. And each time they hit the monster frog, little frogs came out of it and inundated the country of Egypt. Now, if these were not normal frogs, the people were also not normal. How nasty they must have been to hit that huge frog. Why couldn't they simply leave it alone, but instead they had to abuse it? The ridiculous situation of belief in a Godzilla frog comes from the mistake of taking a midrash literally. In fact, it seems to have been a midrash spoken by Rabbi Akiva, and therefore, it should simply be understood as a stock joke that he used to tell to cheer people up. It's similar to the stock joke that Rabbi Akiva had about multiple births. The story goes that once when he was giving a class, his students were nodding off and falling asleep. Thereupon, Rabbi Akiva said, "How do we know that a woman can give birth to thousands at the same time?" The students woke up. "Huh? What did the rabbi say?" Rabbi Akiva then told them a midrash about Yocheved and said that if she was the midwife, according to that tradition, then all the babies that she saved, she became the mother of them. So the students must have had a good laugh and returned again to their studies. The midrash was told just to wake people up. It certainly was not ever meant to be taken literally. But there are people who try to make it into an article of faith. And if you don't believe it, you are a heretic. The issue is, and we've seen the fundamentalist perspective of teachers in Brooklyn, how exactly were the plagues understood and experienced by the ancient Israelites as miracles? And how do we understand miracles? And how do we, who live thousands of years later, integrate it into our faith? In the search for an answer, the key text, perhaps, is found at the end of the Torah reading for this week. At Exodus 9, verses 31 and 32, we read, "The flax and the barley were destroyed, because the barley was in the ear and the flax in bud, but the wheat and spelt were not destroyed, because they ripen later." With the coming observance of Tu B'Shvat, we recall that there are several growing seasons in the Middle East. There is both an early sprouting of grain and a later one. The Torah is telling us that when the plague of locusts comes later on, it is the wheat and the spelt that they destroy, because they had not come up from the ground and consequently were not destroyed by the earlier plague of hail. We may ask, therefore, if it was God's miracle, why was that which was below the ground not destroyed? If we are discussing a miracle, then nothing is beyond God's power. But the text tells us why. Because it was late. The miracle of hail, according to those teachers in Brooklyn, should have hit the wheat and the spelt wherever it was to be found. But if we say that the text of the Torah describes normal barad, then it is describing the normal, natural aspect of hail. Now, what we call normal, the plagues were perhaps not, because it was certainly much more severe. Indeed, the Torah tells us that it had never hailed like that before in Egypt. So yes, it was terrible hail, severe, but it was natural. Why do some people believe that God always wants to overturn his own world? It is so curious. Why did God use hail, a part of his original creation? Why not produce dinosaurs to appear and eat and trample the crops? Thus we see that the Torah gives us great insights into the faith of our ancestors. Our ancestors experienced God in their everyday life, not as beyond, but as very close. They saw God as bound up in all the details of every aspect of existence. And they preserved for us the fruits of their labor, which we harvest if we can learn to read slowly closely and with great care. We may identify many of their actions as superstition and magic, yet it was their science. The ancients used every possible tool at their disposal to understand the world they lived in. And while their science is all bogus from our vantage point, thousands of years afterwards, it doesn't mean that we should stand in judgment of them or ridicule them. But on the other hand, if we who live in a post-nuclear age seek God through the realm of superstition or illogic, we will not only shame our noble ancestors, but we will also never reach our goal. Additionally, we would be guilty of paganism and heresy. The Torah presents the 10 plagues in a deliberate way to teach us how our ancestors approached faith in God. Their purpose is to emphasize the idea that the plagues, while they were most certainly natural disasters and not supernatural events, they were the deliberate and purposeful acts of divine will. And their intent is to educate. Even as the plagues are God's judgments on Egypt for the enslavement of the Israelites, they are meant to demonstrate to Egypt the impotence of all that is pagan, and by contrast, the incomparability of the God of Israel as the one supreme sovereign God of creation who uses and works through the phenomena of the natural order for his own purposes. Let's leave Godzilla to the excellent and entertaining realm of sci-fi and fantasy, but let us take to heart and mind the lessons of biblical miracles. We need to read our Torah texts over and over to sit with these images and relish them and let them become part of our prayer life and our vocabulary and our conceptual framework. That process will yield great spiritual insights and bring us closer to serving God in truth. We would like to thank all those who have made contributions to the Meldado Kiddush Fund in memory of their loved ones whose Anya will be commemorated in the week to come. Thank you to Terry and Stanley Elias, Alan Elias, Patty and Mark Renton, Marianne Zakaria, Shelley and Dr. Norman Breyer, Suzanne Breyer, Estelle and Andrew Ross, Mona Zakaria Bierman and Robert Bierman, Dorothy Goldsmith, Francis and Nathan Grama, Shoshana Sharabi, Linda Sharabi and Selim Garon, Arthur Miller, Annie Lynn Miller, Susan Miller, Rochelle Gray, Evelyn Samaya, Pauline and Isidore Cohen, Libby Grill, Lisa and Lev Hernson, Ricky and David Grill, Cheryl Bluestein, Randy and Larry Gelb, Sylvia Wiener, Francis and Stephen Wiener, Diana Asale, Mildred Averco, Andrea and Dr. Daron Wiener, Marion and Mark Siegel, Jacqueline Glabman, and Eileen and Robert Roman. For those who are looking forward to commemorating the Meldado, the Shabbat of a Anyo, Yortzeit, or Nahala of a loved one, but won't be praying with us in person at the synagogue, we will once again read the Hashkabot, the memorial prayers, today on Erev Shabbat. Our intention is to bring honor to the deceased, to strengthen the hearts of those who remember, and to console those who mourn. We will also read a prayer for those who are in need of healing. Tov shem yishem en tov yom ha-maved miyom yivaledo, sof dabar ha-kol nishma, et ha-elohim yira v'mitzvotav shemor ki zeh kol ha-adam. Menucha nechona b'shiva elyona tach ha-kanfei ha-shechina, sham tehei menad m'chitzad b'shivat nefesh ha-shem ha-tov. Yitzchak Gavriel Dasa, v'gam Howard Ross, Chaim Yosef ben Mordechai Renton, Chaim Avraham Saporta, Yechiel Michael ben Chaim Bergenfeld, Zelig ben Nisim Glabman, Benjamin ben Shlomo Elias, Chanoch Yosef ben Louis Label Vaperel Grill, Shemaya ben Todros Samaya, Mordechai ben Chaim Roman, Moshe ben Yitzchak Wiener, Avraham Yosef Kasuto, Yitzchak ben Chaim Zakaria, Aharon Ber ben Shemuel Tanzman, Avraham Menachem Zakaria, Simon Pesso, Solomon J. Altman, Isaac H. Asher, Zimbel Bar David, Nathan Kamai, Jack Shiprut, Jacob I. Cohen, Chaim I. Crespi, Aaron R. Crespi, Sam M. Fintz, Meyer J. Levy, Solomon I. Lomita, Raphael Maya, Simon C. Pesso, Jess Colcamiro, Jack Crespi, Aaron Elias, Jacob Elias, Lance Klein, Isidore Namius, Gerald Russo, Israel Noah Shulam, Benjamin Simons, Solomon Wool, Isaac Yochai, Vigam, Moshe ben Avraham Sharabi, Chaim ben Pinchas Levi, Avraham ben Avraham Visser, Mordechai Label Seaver, Yoram ben Shlomo Hassas, Mordechai ben Benjamin Sugarman, Yitzchak ben Eliezer Vieta Halevi Greenberg, Harav Avraham Dov ben Aharon Verisha Marins, David ben Bela Betesh, Tevel ben Sima Slepian, Shraga ben Noach Vahadasa Rosen, Reuven ben Arthur Veruth Bluestein, Shemuel ben Moshe Russo, Chaim Yecheskel Shraga ben Yitzchak Yaakov, Eliyahu Daniel Susi, Binyamin Teleki ben Pesach, Yehuda Gold ben Avraham Verachel Leah. Ruach Adonai Tinihem Began Eden, HaMelech Berachamav Yechos V'yachmo Aleihem, V'leve Eilehem HaShalom, HaMishkabam Yehiyah Shalom. Heim V'chol B'nei Yisrael HaShochabim Imahem, B'chlal HaRachamim V'HaSalichot, V'chein Yehi Ratzon, V'nomar Amen. Eishech HaYamim Sav Rachok Mipinini Mikra, Tenula Mipiri Adea, V'halalu Haba Sh'arim Ma'aseha, Rachmana D'Rachmanuna Dilehi, Yema'ala Ma'akadmohi Dukhran Ha'isha HaNichbedet, Kadun H. Russo, Vagam Fanny Stillman, Peggy Cohen Arroyo, Malka Kleinman bat Moshe Chaim, Chana Cohen bat Presia, Estelle Sarfati, Sarah Taibi, Rivka Mordechai Cohen, Sarah Eshet Shlomo Bensol, Reina Yaakov Hatem, Stamula Moshe Kamai, Tilly Baruch, Sarah Stern, Zoila I. Bambanasti, Rachel N. Barrow, Esther Farhi, Malka Bihar, Perla Ben Ruby, Esther Ben Ruby, Anna Cohen, Esther Confino, Gilda Francis, Rachel Matzel, Betty Rosenfeld, Rita Sherman, Vigam, Ruth Eshet, Chaim Levy, Donna Ben Nisim of Esther Baruch, Bryna Miller Bat Aharon, Devorah Bat Yaakov Hana Eshet Yitzchak Franco, Etel Betel Ben Signor Ben Wolf Yehiel, Leah Sarah Lewis Bat Henya, Ruth Bat Rafael Vagrazia Bahalul, Esther Bat Harav Shimon Vabat Sheva, Allegra Zakaria Corman, Perel Devorah Eshet Yehuda Perlman, Esther Gatenya Bat Arya Vamalka, Esther Marcus Bachaim Vamazel Tov, Luna Clara Bachaim Verivka Jamil, Basha Granit Bat Moshe Arya Vabela, Millie Bat Ezra Sarah Harari, Sarah Letterman Bat Yaakov Vimiriam, Rachel Bat Shimon Vester Peso, Ishit Chaim Halio, Amalia Aranya Bat Eliyahu Vesara, Sarah Bauman Bat Shalom Vachana Elias, Sarah Gershon Maya, Ruach Adonai Tinihem Began Eden, HaMelech Berachamav Yechos V'yachmo Aleihem, V'leve Eliyahem HaShalom, HaMishkaban Yehiyah Shalom. Hen V'chol B'not Yisrael HaShochabot Imahen, B'chlal HaRachamim V'HaSalichot, V'chein Yehi Ratzon, V'nomar Amen. Misha Beirach Abotinu Abraham Yitzhak V'Yaakob, Sarah, Rivka, Rachel V'Leya, Hu Yibarech Et HaCholim, Moshe Ben Yaakov Letterman, V'gam Shalama Daniela Bat Chava Radek, Simcha Eshet Moshe Wiener, Joseph Schechter, Nisim ben Eliyahu ben Signor, Nisim ben Rafael Vasonia Aminov, Sarah Green bat Rivka Lea, Zion bat Amalia Gilberg, Chana Halfon bat Rachel, Meir Moshe ben Noach Rosen, Miriam Roth bat Moshe, Yosef ben Yaakov, Yitzchak ben Chana Aloni, Chaim ben Meir Hillel Vadona Goldsmith, Zahava Eshet Rachamim Franco, Shoshana Garber, Clara Bat Kochava, Yisrael Pinchas ben Chaim Shapiro, Fliegel Shalom Blaustein bat Etalea, Herschel Bauman, Shalomo ben Chana Elias, Yocheved Hand bat Runya Fremet, Elka Shendel Winkler bat Sura, Fega Rivka Bachana, Baruch Eliezer ben Gila, Avraham ben Fortuna Sayeg, Meir ben Avraham, Or ben Vered Varon Masarano, Leah Lind bat Solika, Jackie Perazzo, Shulamit Cohen bat Rachel, Yerachmiel ben Shemuel Samaya, Rachel bat Zimbulyani, Ita bat Frida, Zalman ben Sarah. Hamakom yishlach lehem refuah shelema, refuat hanefesh, urefuat haguf. El na refana lehem, vachlimam, vachziram le'etanam, v'chein yihi ratzon, v'nomar, amen. O Lord, we also pray for the victims who have perished during this coronavirus pandemic and for their survivors. May your love and compassion be upon them all. May you provide consolation for those who mourn. For those who are quarantined either willingly or due to their having been infected, please, God, watch over them, give them strength in their time of isolation and anxiety, heal them and shield them from despair. May the Holy One bless first responders and medical personnel who risk their lives, and may God grant expertise and grace to all whose hearts, bodies, and minds are called into use for the sake of those who are infected. May God grant success to all members of our armed forces and law enforcement who work diligently to protect us from harm. Yehi ratzon milifnei abinu shebashamayim, la'atzor hamagifa v'hamashkit me'aleinu, u'me'al kol olamo, v'imru amen. May it be the will of our Father in heaven to avert disease and destruction from us and from his entire world, and let us say amen. Erev Shabbat Shalom, Boas Entradas, from the Sephardic Temple of Cedarhurst.